Okay, let's get started. Let's create our project. Now, one of the hardest parts of using React with Express and Node is simply setting up the project. So I've created a sample project to do this for us so we don't have to start from scratch. So if you go to bit.ly/express-react-starter, that will open up a browser. You can go to GitHub and you can just grab this starter template here, which makes it super easy to get started with debugging and running them both in the same project and everything. So back here, we'll just do git clone, and then we're gonna clone it into a folder called React CosmosDB. Okay, cool, then we'll move into the React CosmosDB folder, and we'll run an npm install. And I will see you on the other side of this thing, because this is boring. And we're back. Okay, let's open this in Visual Studio Code. And let's have a look at what's inside this project. So there's really two main pieces of this project that you need to know about. The first one is this source folder here, which contains all of the React portion of the application. This is generated by Create React App, and it is Create React App living in this folder. In this folder here is where the server portion lives. So Express and Node are running right here. Now these two things have to run on separate processes. The front end runs on a Webpack server, and the back end runs, of course, on the Node server. It is a Node server. So to run these two things, we need to fire them up separately. So to run the React portion, it is the same as create React app, it's just npm start from the terminal. And then to run the backend portion of the application, we come over here to the debug tab, and I've got some launch configurations in here for you already. Just choose launch server, press the green button, and that will launch the server portion. And if we take a look here, I'll refresh this and we'll get a message back. So let's talk about how to debug for a second. If we're debugging the front end, we can do that here in the browser DevTools the way that we normally would. So let's say we wanted to debug this message here, because this message actually comes from the Express Node server. So I know that this happens in the app.js file. So I can just open up app.js and then I can drop a breakpoint right here. So if I was to refresh, then we'll hit the breakpoint. Okay. And it's going to /API/message. All right. So we'll continue through there. And then if we want to debug on the server, let's go over there. We can debug here as well. So all of our API calls are going to go to the server folder and then into the routes to this index route here. Anything that's /API comes to the routes. Anything else is going to be redirected to the React front end. So in this index.js file, we can put a breakpoint here and then go back and refresh. So let's do the same thing. It'll hit this breakpoint first. Let's step through and it hits our breakpoint and we can go ahead and change this. We can actually say res.json. Let's say welcome to React CosmosDB with, let's do some fire emoji here for effect. Perfect. So we can send that back and continue on. And yep, now we're welcome to React CosmosDB. So this is how the application runs and debugs. Now, another thing to notice is that let's look at the AJAX call that's made here for this message. So if we refresh, and I'm gonna go ahead and step on through, move this breakpoint. We're gonna go back to welcome to React, and that's fine. And let's look at the network tab. In the network tab, you'll see that we're calling /API/message, which is right here, /API/message. And it looks like it's going to port 3000. So it looks like the React app and the server are running in the same project. But our little server back here is actually running on port 3001. And to prove that to you, I'm gonna come up here and copy this over and 3001 and /API/message. And look at what we get back, welcome to React. How is that possible? Well, it's possible thanks to a proxy function of create React app. So React proxies all requests that are /API to port 3001. Now, when we run this thing in production, it looks a little bit different. In production, what we'll do is we'll run npm run build like that. And what that's gonna do is build the front end, and then you'll notice that it's gonna drop the front end into the server folder inside of a build folder. So I'll let you see that when that comes up here in a second, and there it is. So this is all of our React app now built for production, and everything in the server folder is what we would deploy. And now that everything is in the same folder, check this out. We can go ahead and fire up our server. If we head back to the browser, on port 3001, API message is still gonna return /API/message, but look at what the root will return. It returns the application. So this is exactly what we want, a development environment where we have hot reload and debugging, and a production environment where both React and Express are running on the same URL. And that's what the Express React Starter gives you. Now that we've got our project set up, we're ready to start building the application. And that's exactly what we're going to do in the next episode. I'll see you on the other side.